is learn as much information you can about your business, because it's always somebody that is going to take you out your spot. And yes, this is a competition. You may say that you're not in competition with somebody, but why would you want somebody else that's doing the same thing you're doing when you got great quality, and they might not even have great quality, to steal your customers? So make sure you do your research in the field that you are in. Welcome back to my channel. If you don't know me, my name is Molly LeFlair. And if you do know me, welcome back, sis. Because, period. Yes, I am so excited because I have been literally waiting to make this video for months now. As always, with all my videos, I'm always waiting months. I don't know why. I always stumble on making videos. And I have so much content to bring to you guys. I feel bad because, like, I don't bring it out, and I know it's needed. Look, I keep clapping, but I know it's needed because just like I was like struggling with my business, I know a lot of you guys are struggling, especially if you like not able to get a job, like underage wise. And I know it's hard. I was in that position as well. So I want to let you guys know you have no worries. Now I am going to help you out. So, we need to not worry no more. I'm gonna give you like a lot of tips. Honestly, these tips, I would say, I wouldn't like necessarily put an age on it, but in order to like get funding, I think you have to be like 18 and older. So I'm not sure. So I'm sorry if they disappoint you guys, if you under the age of 18. I think you have to be 18 to apply to some of these fundings. So let's get on to the video. So I have my notepad right now. I am recording on my phone, so I cannot use my phone. I wish I could, but I do have my notepad, so same thing. I want to let you guys know like 5 fundings that you can actually apply for that work. I did apply for only one of them out of the 5, but I do know other business, small business owners like me that applied for them and got funded. First one in place is SoGal Foundation, a black foundation for small business owners, like for startup grants. Even if you already in business and already started your business, and you are a small business, you still can apply for it. So don't worry, because it was one of my worries that I had already started my business and it's a startup loan. So don't worry, you can still apply for it if you are a small business owner. The next one is Women's Startup Challenge Tech Grant. That's the one I actually got funded from. So I know it does work. You guys, I can't tell you guys how much I did get, but I did get a great amount. And it is a grant, it's not a loan actually. I know I did say that some of these are loans. So grants are where they actually give you the money and you don't have to pay it back. A loan is when you have to pay it back, of course, because it's in the name, a loan. It's a loan. So with a grant, you don't have to worry about it. And also another one that I did not put on this paper is SBA loan. I know they offered me some money, but it was like a loan, it wasn't a grant, and I did not accept it. It was other things that went on with it. I couldn't get it anyways, to be honest, like, because I think it was something about 2019. I didn't have my tax returns for 2019. So before I get into this, I'm going to let you guys know that please, to the people that's over the age of 18, because you can file your taxes yourself. If you are under the age of 18, I think you have to put the business like in someone's name and they have to file that themselves. So it wouldn't actually be under you, I don't think. I don't know how that goes, so do not quote me. But you want to make sure you file your taxes and keep up with certain things, because some, like getting loans, getting grants, like you must have certain things, documents showing that you are in business and that you actually have a legit business and making money from this business. Another thing is getting your business registered. You always want to make sure your business is register with the state that you are in, and also have an EIN, which is like a social security for your business, which are two different things. Guys, I don't know about you guys, but that's something that I did not know. And I don't know, maybe I'm just slow as hell, but honestly, I did not know this. Nobody told me. I really did not do the research. So if you are in business and you really love your business, learn as much information you can about your business, because it's always somebody that is going to take you out your spot. And yes, this is a competition. You may say that you're not in competition with somebody, but why would you want somebody else that's doing the same thing you're doing when you got great quality, and they might not even have great quality, to steal your customers? So make sure you do your research in the field that you are in. So that is very important. That's something that I did mess up on starting my business. I did not do much research like I should have. So please do research. Please get your business registered with the state. Get an EIN. Oh yeah, and the other stuff with the website stuff, like .com, get a domain, all that stuff. You wanna be legit as possible. You do not want to be having half of the items and then don't have anything. You guys, I was in business and I made $85,000 my first year with Shopify. And y'all, I didn't have a business banking account. That was the biggest thing. That was the biggest fuck up I had. Like, I'm so upset about that. Like, you guys do not understand how much, because I don't miss out on so much money. You can miss out on so much money. You never know when your business gonna like blow up. So go in it with the mindset that your business is gonna blow up, because you're gonna have great quality, great content, you're gonna have nice pitch. Everything is just gonna be A1. So the mindset is, you may not be making money now, but you soon will be making money. And that is the mindset. So you guys, please be careful with having a business. This is not a game at all. You want to take this serious. You do not want to be working for nobody all your life. Don't get me wrong, it's nothing wrong with having a 9-to-5. So do not be discouraged with it. Don't let nobody take you off your grind, sis. If you got a job, you got a business, do your thing. Going to school, sis, you was on point. You're doing the right thing, period. So the third thing is Fund Women Universal Grant. I did, my friend that I know has been in business for a year now. She did apply for that one as well. And the next one is grant.gov. I don't know nothing about that too much, but I heard that people was actually getting funding from that. I mean, getting a grant from that. So most of these are grants, and grants are good. I try to put mostly grants instead of loans on here. But the next one, I think, is Bumble Fund, and I think that actually is a grant as well. Don't quote me on that. I did apply for that, got denied, but you not me, and I'm not you. So you can apply for it. Do not be discouraged. Just because I got denied doesn't mean you're going to get denied. So those are the top five ones that I would recommend. And the next thing is that I learned from, but while I'm looking for this, I want to let you guys know to go to a small bank and get a savings account. So I think this is it. This is that. I got this from Noelle Randell. I think that's how you pronounce her last name. She is the best in business. You guys should go check out her channel, because I promise you, I learned so much from that lady, literally. So this is what I'm going to tell you guys that I did get from her, is to go get a checking account. I mean, a savings account with a small bank. And when I say small bank, not some of those small banks that's only in your city. Small banks is like PNC, Regions, Wells Fargo's. You guys want to get a savings account with those small banks, because they have so much to offer, trust me. And I got every last one of them. So the thing is with that, when you get a savings account, deposit $1,000 to $1,500 in that savings account. Ask for a loan on top of that savings loan. And no matter if you got bad credit or anything like that, bad personal credit, it does not matter. They will give you a loan on top of this. If you put $1,500 in your savings account and you get the loan, they will give you another $1,500. You do that from different banks. If you do that with all three banks, Regions, Wells Fargo's, PNC, let's just say actually deposit $1,000 into each one of them, it'll get a loan on top of your savings. So there will be $2,000 that you will have, and then you will have $4,000, and then you have $6,000. That is a huge way you guys can get funding for your business. Also, you can build your personal credit, which is very, very, very important. Something that I was like lost with. I was lost with a lot of stuff, so let's just say that. But you guys, that is a smart as idea. And that's the smartest way that, to me, that I feel like you can get funding for your business. You guys, work your ass off. Do what you gotta do for your business. If you are over the age of 18, you can't get a decent job without having like some type of degree or anything like that. You don't have to have a degree to do these things. You don't have to be smart with school in order to get to where you need to go with your business, you guys. Learn as much as you can with the field that you are in. I hope you guys did enjoy my video. I thank you so much for showing support and watching it. I hope it did help. So, without further ado, see you guys later. I talk on my hands a lot.